Welcome to Bologna for Lamborghini's 50th birthday celebrations. And if you're wondering where the heck the party's at, look down here.
You join me at Bologna Piazza on the final leg of a 5-day tour of 350 Lamborghinis, with a total of 190,000 horsepower travelling from Milan to the firm's factory in Sant'Agata Bolognese. So let's meet some of the owners and their cars.
Right, we have Chris Singh from
Jupiter, Florida, United States.
And you've brought with you a
Aventador, it's right here.
I wrapped it in a brushed steel. Company in US called Detailing Dynamics did it and came up with a great design, and I'm very happy with it. Yeah, I love my car.
Have you done anything else to your Aventador?
I added some carbon fiber interior, but that's about it. I mean, the car is perfect. You know, they really made a perfect car, in my opinion.
Now, I've heard that you've just bought another Lamborghini, a very special Lamborghini. Is that correct?
Yeah, I've bought a couple recently, yeah.
What are they?
I ordered the anniversary edition of this, the Roadster version.
Yeah.
And I'm going to keep this as well. And I ordered the Veneno.
Yeah, I heard about that.
Yeah.
When are you getting that?
I think Q4 this year.
Okay. Would have been cool to have brought that to this event,
wouldn't it? I asked them if it was possible, but, and they wanted to, but they just couldn't get it built and finished in time.
Still, that's not a bad way to travel anyway, is it?
No, I have no complaints. No.
So, Stefan Winkelmann's signature, yes. The boss of Lamborghini, who we'll probably see wandering around here later.
He like this. Yes.
I wonder if you get the same response from the boss of Ferrari if he did this to one of his cars. Then, I guess Lamborghini knows its customers a little bit flamboyant.
It's the first time I've ever seen Lamborghinis outdone by a set of shoes, but you've got some crazy shoes on there.
And if the shoes weren't showy enough, how about a Lambo birthday bracelet with 50 commemorative diamonds?
You might be wondering what these two guys are doing. Well, he is controlling a quadcopter up there, which is filming the Lamborghinis down below. And that guy with the headgear on is pretty much seeing what the camera is seeing on that quadcopter.
So what exactly can you see through the glasses? I asked if I could take a look.
Whoa! I can actually see myself. Hi, Matt.
Now, you'd think that the quadcopter pilot would be the biggest Lamborghini fan in the world, considering all the cool cars he could see.
Okay, if you have to choose one, Lamborghini or Ferrari?
I don't know.
Really? Come on. Today, surrounded by all these Lamborghinis?
Ferrari!
He said Ferrari!
Yeah.
Cut!
How could he say Ferrari? Hadn't he seen the stunning red Lamborghini Miura S, which won a special honour in the Concorso d'Eleganza? Amazingly, its Swiss owner, Adrian Gattiger, had only had the car for a year, and it was his first ever Lamborghini.
Can you tell us a bit about your car?
It's built 1970, was then straight going into Switzerland, and had then one owner in southern Switzerland. Then he came to the city of St. Gall for 35 years. Then a friend of mine bought it and did some restoration. Then all of a sudden I heard he wants to sell it on an auction. I said, you're crazy, you cannot do that, and I bought it. Here I am.
We've got Joshua King from Hampstead in London here with a
Lamborghini LP560 coupe, four-wheel drive.
So you've come all the way from England.
Yes.
And you've been driving the whole procession. How's that been?
It's been absolutely phenomenal. You know, been organised brilliantly, come through, the police over here have been fantastic. I don't know if you've been in any of the cars here, but the police stop at roundabouts, they tell anybody that cuts in to get out the way, move away, just been unbelievable.
And they turn a blind eye when you open the car up?
I've done about 180, so, you know.
Okay, that's
a good friend of mine did about 206.
Really?
It appears the Italian police are a little bit cooler than your average traffic cop. Well, when it's Lamborghini's birthday anyway.
So how fast have people been going?
300 kilometers.
Okay.
Kilometers an hour. True. These are not Californian highways.
I've just come across a very special Lamborghini here. in Bologna, and that's because it's a concept car. It's a Lamborghini Carla. Now, there's only three of these ever made, and I remember seeing this in an issue of Auto Express back in 1995, and I really hope they build it, but unfortunately they didn't. It's designed by Giorgetto Giugiaro, and it's actually been bought here today by his son Fabrizio.
Soon it was time to leave Bologna Piazza and head off in convoy to the grand finale of the 50th birthday celebrations.
Okay, we're going to go off to the Lamborghini factory now in Sant'Agata. That's part of the procession, so this should be pretty exciting. So long as I don't prang the car, it could be embarrassing. Here we go. That. It's the Araka ahead of me.
Get out of the way, fool, for today I have complete immunity from all motoring laws.
When Lamborghinis, we have right of way always.
But that wasn't all.
Look, we don't actually need sat nav, we've got Lamborghini nav today. There we go. Well, we've got about 15 kilometres to go to the factory, so I'm going to give you a quick review of the Aventador Roadster. So I've got a 6.5 litre V12, 700 horsepower, all-wheel drive, 0 to 60, 3 seconds, top speed 217 miles an hour, though, yeah, I'm kind of doing about 30 miles an hour now. It's all right at 30, actually. You just put it into neutral and do that occasionally to keep yourself entertained.
But while I was happy to drive like Miss Daisy, some of the Lamborghini drivers were in more of a hurry and displayed some classic Italian driving techniques. So, I gave chase.
Now I'm getting Euro fumes up my nose. Yoo-hoo! Oh, look at all these people. Let's give them an earful. Oh, this is great with all the Italians. They've just turned out to see this procession of Lamborghinis. And I don't think that if you had a similar kind of event in the UK, it'd have the same response. They're just all going crazy.
I thought maybe I should go a little bit crazy too, and so opened up the Aventador one last time before I had to give it back.
Oh, that was quick.
Finally, the convoy arrived at the Lamborghini factory. And as I crossed the threshold, I was in no doubt that while this may be the end of an epic road trip, it wasn't going to be the end of the celebrations. And I was right, because the party continued well into the night.